Good morning, my dear students, my dear sweet chocolates. I am your English teacher, and today we are going to start the notebook work. So, before that, let's recall whatever we had done in the previous lectures. So, we had done the explanation. Yeah, you have understood the chapter well. Okay. Then after that, we had done the exercise in the book. The exercise that is given on page number 5. Two exercises are given. Two questions. First is the true and false, and second is to tick the correct answer. Okay, so we have done this. Now, if you will turn the pages in the book, you will find some more exercises that are given. But we are not going to do it just now. We will do it later on, because all these exercises that are given on page number 7, page number 8, and so on, all the exercises. These exercises are related to grammar. Okay, so whenever we will start the grammar part, we will do these exercises that time. So, now let me tell you something about how to maintain and how to make the notebooks. So, two notebooks you have to make. How many notebooks? Two notebooks. One will be for the grammar portion and one will be for the literature. Okay, so one will be for literature, L-I-T-E-R-A-T-U-R-E, and one will be for grammar, G-R-A-M-M-A-R, grammar. Okay, now you must be wondering, literature. Literature means all those things, all the chapters that are given in your this book, literature book. This is your literature book. Okay. So, and the other one will be for grammar. And I hope you have purchased the books. The literature book and the grammar book is a 5-in-1 combined book. In that book, you will find 5 subjects. Its name is Pansy. P-A-N-S-Y, Pansy. What is the name of your 5-in-1 book? Pansy. P-A-N-S-Y, Pansy. Okay, so in this book, what subjects are there? The English grammar, Hindi grammar, general knowledge, value education, and computer. Okay, so purchase the book from the market. Then, so two notebooks we are going to make. Now we will write the question answer and the chapter 1, the literature things, in the literature notebook. So open your notebook. The four line notebook will work the same that you have made in class 1. Okay. Okay. So open your notebook. Keep a pencil, a sharp pencil. Okay, with you, and eraser and all the stationery that you have. Now, what is the first thing that we do in the notebook? We write the index. We fill up the index. Okay. So in your index, the serial number is given, right? Serial number, topic. No, I think the date is written there. Serial number, date. Then topic, okay. Then remarks and so on. Okay, so we are not concerned with that part of the index. We are concerned with the three most important parts of the index. So, serial number 1 you will write date, whatever date there is, whatever date the lecture you are seeing on. So, today's date is 23rd of June. So, I am writing that date. You will write the date on which this lecture you are seeing. Okay. So, 23rd of June I am writing 23-6-20. Okay. Now, topic is, write the topic in short. See, chapter number 1 in the bracket. First thing we are going to do is the hard words. Okay, we are going to start with the hard words. Hard words. And in the line below, because this topic line is this portion is very small in your notebook, so write it on the line below. Hard words, comma, word meanings. Okay, so today we are going to do two things. That is hard words. That means the new words, or you may call it dictation words also. Hard words and new word meanings.
word meaning. M-E-A-N-I-N-G. Word meanings.
Okay, so do this. Write it fast in your notebook. Write it down fast. I am getting a site so that you can see the word clearly. This is for your index page, I-N-D-E-X. It is written over there on the page, okay? And all the notebooks have this page in the beginning. Write it down fast. Okay, and for those who have not written the index, the slow writers, they can take the screenshot, okay? Okay, so now open a new, a fresh page of your notebook, the first page probably, and start writing these. Okay, now first listen carefully how you have to write in your notebook. For example, this is your margin. You have this pink color margin na, in your notebook. This is your margin and this is your writing area. Okay, in the margin area, we generally write the numbers. Okay, the bullets. So, we will write these. The bullets or the numbers in this margin area, and in this area, this writing main area, first write down the date, and the date column is given here, okay, on this side of the page. Okay, so whatever date is there, write it. Whatever date you have written in the index, write it there. Okay, then after that start writing from where the four lines of your notebook begin. The first section of the four lines. Okay, the first set of the four lines. For example, this is your margin na? This is your uppermost margin. Okay, on the above of it, the blank space is there. Write it down below. These four lines are given. 1, 2, 3, 4 lines are there na in your notebook. The first set of four lines. Write the name of the chapter there. Okay. C-H-A-P-T-E-R, chapter number 1, okay? Make the C capital, don't make it small, okay? So, I hope this is clear to you. Many students do what, you know? They write this chapter number 1, this heading on this line, on this margin line. That is for me, is a little disturbing. Don't write like this, okay? Write it on the first set of the your four lines, first set of four lines. Then below down on the second line, on the second set of four lines, okay, write down the name of the chapter, the 1-inch warrior, T-H-E, the O-N-E-1, O capital, T capital, this T will be capital, this O will be capital, dash, this small line is called a dash, I-N-C-H, 1-inch, and warrior, W capital, okay, W-A-R-R-I-O-R, 1-inch warrior, okay, write it fast. We will start the first question, the very first question. Write down number A on this side of the margin. Okay, write down number A. The first question of yours is hard words. We are beginning with the hard words. Hard words, or you may call it new words. Okay, the hard words of the chapter. Write it first, come on. okay? So the first word is warrior. Write the number properly, okay? Number one, warrior. W A double R I O R, warrior. Okay, repeat it after me. W A double R I O R, warrior. W A double R I O R, warrior. Write it first. First word, warrior. You know what is mean by warrior? A fighter. Who was the warrior in the story? Yes, Isan Moshi was the warrior, the 1-inch warrior. Okay. Then number two, on the next line you will write it. S W O R D, sword. Okay, sword, talwar. Write it fast. Come on. And write as beautifully as you can, okay? If needed, use the eraser, but don't use the eraser too much. It will torn out your page, okay? And rub very, very slowly, okay? Rub carefully. Second word done. Now number third. Third word is number three, needle. N double E D L E, needle. N double E D L E, needle. N double E D L E, needle. Okay. Then number four. B O W L, bowl. Don't call it bowl. Okay, that's wrong. Bowl. What is that? Bowl. So four words are there: warrior, sword, needle, and bowl. Write it down fast. Come on. Okay, done. Word number five. Word number five is wonderful. W O N D E R, wonder. F U L, full. Okay. Wonderful. W O N D E R, wonder. F U L, full. Wonderful. Okay, now since I have no space in the board, as you can see, so that's why I am writing on the other side. If your notebook is filled up, if one side of your notebook is filled up, no need to write it on the next page. You can write it on the side as I am writing, okay? But since you must be having some space under it, so you will write the other words there, okay? So number six. Word number six is serve. S E R V E, serve. Okay, S E R V E, serve. S E R V E, serve. Do you know the meaning of wonderful? Who was having a wonderful house? Lord Sanjo was having a wonderful house. Wonderful means shandar. Okay. Then you know the meaning of warrior, right? Sword. Sword. The talwar. Okay. Needle. The needle is that thing by which, with the use of which, Isan Boshi's father made a sword for him. So Isan Boshi's father made a sword with the help of a needle. Okay. Out of a needle. Then needle means sui in Hindi. Okay. Then bowl. Soup bowl in which Isan Boshi sailed to the city. Okay. Then wonderful. And then surf. seven. Seventh word is giant. G I A N T. Giant. Okay. G I A N T. Giant. G I A N T. Giant. Are you able to see the board? And I hope my handwriting is clear to you. And parents, for the slow writers, you can take the screenshot of the screen. Then word number 8 is swallow. S W A L L O W. Swallow. Okay? Swallow. S W A L L O W. Swallow means to eat up. Okay? Who swallowed in this chapter? Giant swallowed. Giant swallowed Isan Boshi in the chapter, right? Then word number 9 is hammer. H A double M E R. Hammer. Okay. What type of hammer was there in the chapter? A normal hammer or a magical hammer? Yes, correct. A magical hammer. Okay. H A double M E R. Hammer. Hammer means in Hindi we call it hathoda. Okay. Number 9. Hammer. H A double M E R. Hammer. And try to note down the correct spelling. Don't write incorrect spelling in your notebook. Okay? Try to write in the cursive writing and make all the letters clear and proper. Okay? And yeah, one more thing. These numberings you will write on this margin side. Okay? As I have written on this side. Right? So you will write all these numberings in the margin side. When you will move on to this side, you will write the numberings as I have written. Then number 10. And probably the last hard word. Intelligent. I-N-T-E-L-L-I-G-E-N-T. Intelligent. Intelligent. Are you all intelligent? Yes. And who was intelligent in this story? Yes, Isan Boshi was the intelligent boy in this story. Okay. So, I-N-T-E-L-L-I-G-E-N-T. Intelligent. Yeah, it's a big word for you. But try to read it and learn the spelling. I-N-T-E-L-L-I-G-E-N-T. Intelligent. Okay, so I'm moving aside so that you can write down all the things properly and you can see the things properly. Okay, done. Let's revise it one more time. First word is warrior, that means a fighter. Warrior. Second is sword. Third, needle. N-E-D-D-L-E, needle. Then number 4 is B-O-W-L, bowl. Number 5, wonderful. W-O-N-D-E-R, wonder, F-U-L, full. Number 6 is serve. S-E-R-V-E, serve. Number 7, giant. G-I-A-N-T, giant. Number 8, swallow. S-W-A-L-L-O-W, swallow. Number 9, hammer. H-A-M-M-E-R, hammer. And number 10 is intelligent. I-N-T-E-L-L-I-G-E-N-T, intelligent. Okay? So, write it fast. I hope you have written it already. And for the slow writers, parents, you can take the screenshot of the screen, of the board. Okay? Now I have to rub it. Next thing we are going... One more thing. Why we are writing these hard words? It's a work for you to to learn all the spellings of these words, okay? To learn the spelling of these words and try to pronounce it, okay? We write hard words so that you know how to read these words, how to pronounce these words and how to spell these words correctly. We write these words so that you can know the correct spelling, you learn the correct spelling, okay? So next thing we are going to do is the word meanings. Write the word meanings on a new fresh page. Turn the page and start writing the word meanings there. So this is your margin. On this side of the margin, write number P. Okay? Where you will write it, don't write it above the margin. Write on the first set of four lines you have in your notebook. Okay? I'm repeating it one more time. On the first set of four lines. You have a four line notebook. So you will write, you write the margin, sorry, you write the heading there. What's our heading? Number B, word meanings, W-O-R and W capital. W-O-R-D word, M capital, M-E-A-N-I-N-G-S. Word meanings. F-E-A-N-I-N-G-S. Word meanings, okay? Okay, beta. So, first word is, okay, this word is not there in your book. I mean, it is not there in the word meaning section. Warrior, I am giving this word from my side. W-A-R-R-I-O-R. Warrior. What does it mean? Warrior means a fighter. F-I-G-H-T-E-R, fighter. F-I-G-H-T-E-R, fighter. Okay, now try to write a little faster. Warrior, W-A-R-R-I-O-R, warrior. That means a fighter. Then number two. Buzzing. B-U-Z-Z-I-N-G, buzzing. Okay, let's first complete writing this and then I will explain you the meaning of this. Buzzing, that means making a humming sound. M-A-K-I-N-G, making a H-U-M-M-I-N-G, humming, S-O-U-N-D sound. Sir, is this side visible? S-O-U-N-D sound, making a humming sound, okay? So on the topmost line, you will write the word meanings, the heading. Then a line down below, you will write the first word and its meaning. And below that, the second word and its meaning. And below that, the third word and its meaning. The third word is drove. D-R-O-V-E, drove. Drove means forced to fly, F-O-R-C-E-D, forced. How to read this word? Forced. And this word, D-R-O-V-E, drove, F-O-R-C-E-D, forced. The fly, P-H-E, the F-L-Y, fly, forced the fly to leave, L-E-A-V-E. Okay, and yeah, one more thing, you can find all these words and their meaning in the word meaning section that is given on every page, okay? The pink letters that are given in the chapter, these are the hard words and their meaning is written there on one side below the page. Then number fourth word is pleased. P-L-E-A-S-E-D. Pleased means happy. H-A-P-P-Y, happy. H-A-P-P-Y, happy. And, A-N-D, and satisfied. S-A-T-I-S-F-I-E-D. Satisfied. Happy and satisfied. Happy and satisfied. Please, P-L-E-A, happy and satisfied. Number 5. Poking. P-O-K-I-N-G. Poking. Poking means pricking with a sharp object. P-R-I-C-K-I-N-G. Pricking with a sharp object. Okay, pricking with a sharp object. Just as I am writing clearly, you also have to write all the words and all the letters in your notebook clearly, neatly and as properly as you can. Then number 6, 6th word is spat. S-P-A-T, spat. The two letters got mixed up, so I am rubbing it once again. I am writing it once again. S-P-A-T, spat. Okay, spat means the giant threw. Spat, the meaning here in this chapter, the meaning of a spat is the giant threw Ishan Boshi out of his mouth. Okay, I am writing it right, exactly the same. The giant threw, T-H-R-E-W, threw Ishan Boshi out of his mouth. I-S-S-U-M, Ishan Boshi. But why I am writing I and B capital all the time, every time? Because Ishan Boshi, it's a name and all the names are proper nouns. If you don't know what are proper nouns, we are going to study that in the grammar portion, so don't worry about it. Just simply, Ishan Boshi is a proper noun, that's why we are writing it. We are writing the first letter of it, capital, okay? Ishan Boshi. Giant threw Ishan Boshi out of his mouth, out of his, H-I-S, his, M-O-U-T-H, mouth. Then number 7 is Samurai, S-A-M-U-R-A-I. Samurai. So what is mean by samurai? Samurai means a Japanese soldier, a J-A-P, again J capital of Japanese. Why? Because Japanese, this word is a proper noun. A Japanese, J-A-P-A-N-E-S-E, Japanese soldier, S-O-L-D-I-E-R, soldier of olden times, O-L-D-E-N, olden, T-I-M-E-S, times, and it's over here. Okay, only 7 word meanings are there. So come on, write it fast. Okay, so just I am moving aside so that the parents can take the screenshot of this, or if the child is writing slow. So I am moving aside, you take the screenshot fast. Okay. Portion. Okay, the first word is warrior. Warrior means fighter. Okay, someone who fights. Ishan Boshi was the warrior in our chapter. Then buzzing, making a humming sound. Have you ever seen a fly, a house fly, or a honeybee? Yeah, a honeybee or even a bug that is bigger than the honeybee coming to your house and making a humming sound, a buzzing sound, like this. Okay, so that particular sound that a fly produces is called buzzing. Okay, buzzing sound. Then drove, D-R-O-V-E, drove. Drove means force the fly to leave. Leave means jana. Force the fly to leave. Who forced the fly to leave? Kisne fly ko bhaga diya? Kisne fly ko uda diya? Ishan Boshi forced the fly to leave. And why did he force the fly to leave? because the fly was troubling Lord Sanjo, right? The fly was troubling Lord Sanjo, that's why Kisan Boshi drove the fly away. Okay, usne fly ko uda diya. Fly means pakhi, usne fly ko uda diya.
Then please,
pleased, that means happy and satisfied. Now happy meaning, you know, happy means khush. Satisfied in Hindi, the meaning is santusht. Santusht means no more desire for something. Okay.
Then poking. P-O-K-I-N-G, poking means pricking with a sharp object. Now here the word pricking is also new for you. Pricking means chubhana. Okay. Pricking with a sharp object. That simply means poking also means chubhana. Okay. So who was pricking? Isun Boshi was pricking. And to whom Isun Boshi was pricking? Isun Boshi was pricking the giant. When the giant swallowed it inside his mouth, Isun Boshi was pricking. He was poking the giant with a sharp object. What was that sharp object? The sharp object was this sword that is made out of a needle. Then spat. The giant threw Isun Boshi out of his mouth. Spat means to throw somebody out of the mouth. Muh se bahar nikal dena, fek dena. Okay. Then samurai, the last word, a Japanese soldier of olden times. Olden means prachin, purana time. Okay, so samurai is a Japanese soldier of olden times. In olden times, a Japanese soldier was called a samurai. And that's it for today. I hope you have understood it, and I hope you have written all the things. You will write all the things properly in your notebook. So the homework is to, one more important thing. In your literature notebook, make the homework section. Last year you also made a homework section in your literature notebook, right? This time also you have to make a homework section. That means if, for example, this is your notebook, from the last some 30-40 pages some 30 pages will be enough for the homework section. So in the last, leave some 30-40 pages, take some 30-40 pages and make the homework section here. Okay, so now your homework is to write the word meanings, hard words twice in the homework section. And learn the spellings and learn how to pronounce the words. That's it. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.